Hello, this is Courtney, and I wanted to make Irish soda bread. So today I'm going to be baking, and I'll be using all of these. I'm going to make two loaves because I wanted to make a gluten-free version, so this is going to be my healthy version side, and I wanted to make a normal version too, just in case, because I really love Irish soda bread. So first we're going to do the normal recipe because it takes 50 minutes to bake. The other one only takes 30. So I need 4 cups of all-purpose flour. This will make up for the extra I got. So we're done with that on the perfect side. Next, we're going to add the sugar. So I need 4 tablespoons of white sugar, which I put right there. Okay, so we're about to add 1 tablespoon of sugar. 7, baking powder, salt, and margarine. I'm replacing that with butter. It calls for both butter and margarine, which I thought was weird. So I need 1 tablespoon of baking powder, and this is my baking powder. It seems to be quite a lot. Yep, I hope that's not a typo. Okay, and I need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm gonna need these for this one too. There we go. I'm gonna get a little bit more because I lost some on the way. Okay, so I took care of melting the butter, and now I have this softened butter that I need to add. So I'm going to mix this together. I'm going to get a lot of flour. The butter is kind of crumbling. And it says stir in 1 cup of buttermilk and an egg. And I normally make my own buttermilk. Okay, 1 full cup. I normally make my own buttermilk, but I decided to buy it since I was going to make my favorite bread. Okay. There we go. There is our buttermilk. Now we need our egg. Okay, so now it's going to get really pretty. It doesn't seem to be coming together. There we go. Okay, I think I'm going to add a little bit more buttermilk because it's not sticky. There we go. going to be a huge loaf of bread. And you do not have to let this type of bread rise. You just put it directly in the oven. You cut an X on top. And you can brush it with butter if you like. Which this recipe calls for that, so I'm going to. I'm supposed to grease the pan and you can use pan and cooking spray. But this is a pretty good way to do it. This is how I did it in the olden days. Better bacon fat cooking, cook well for breakfast. There we go. Our pan has been greased. Okay, so let's see. So I'm going to prepare it. So here's my thick, round loaf of bread. And then, hasn't been greased well enough, I guess. Okay. So now I'm going to cut an X on top. Make sure it's deep. Okay, so next I'm supposed to combine melted butter with 1/4 cup of buttermilk. Let's go ahead and roll this in. Okay, so there's 1/4 cup. And here's the melted butter. This is the mixture, and it wants me to brush the loaf with this. Buttermilk and butter. So this is a sweeter bread. Probably why I started liking it the first time I had it. Years ago. There we go. I'll go ahead and put a little extra just in case. Okay, so now I'm going to cut it again. So there we go. It's been cut. Alright, so now I'm going to cook it 45 to 50 minutes, and then we're going to make our gluten-free version. I'm not fully gluten-free. I do do it off and on. It really depends, because I love baked foods. I love baking a lot, so if I can't find a substitute, I do. A lot of the time my family doesn't use it, so I end up, I don't want to not eat something, someone I love to make for me, so I eat it anyway. But when I eventually am out there on my own, I will probably do it gluten-free for the most part. So anyway, now we're on to the shredded bread recipe. It calls for 2 cups of all-purpose flour, but I'm going to replace it gluten-free, which I haven't tried their flour yet, so this is my first time, but I've heard really good reviews. I call it Lemon Sushi or Gluten. I'm going to go ahead and try it out. 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, except I'm using this, and it says it is 1/2 cup to 1 cup, so it's a lot stronger, I'm just going to use 1 tablespoon. So there's my 1 tablespoon. Combine flour, brown sugar, baking powder, baking soda, and salt. How much of these do I need? 1 teaspoon of baking powder. So here's my baking powder. I need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Okay, so I have that. And how much salt? 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Just like the other recipe. Okay, now I'm going to cut in the butter. So I'm using this. It's Irish butter. It's let's see, milk from grass-fed cows. So it's imported, and this is just my, you know, organic, I guess, Irish butter. So I just need 3 tablespoons of this, and I don't know. Oh, there it is. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this stuff. There we go. And I'm going to cut it up before I put it in. It is softened. It's just been sitting on the counter. The recipes didn't say salted or unsalted, so I just kind of used what I had. not all of the flour's getting like that, but I don't think all of it will, since that's not very much butter compared to the flour. Whisk in a smaller bowl, one egg and my buttermilk. Let's go ahead and get our 3/4 cup of buttermilk. So this is 1/4 a cup. I'm just going to do this 3 times. 1, 2, it's like one of those water birds. So buttermilk and 2 eggs. There we go. And I'm just going to set this on this butter wrapper that I'm not using. So now we're going to whisk, and this isn't the best whisk we have, but it's colorful. There we go. So we're going to whisk our eggs and buttermilk. So this is our eggs and our buttermilk. And it says until just moistened. I went ahead and added all of it because I assume I need all of it. Let's hope I'm right. I think I'm right. There we go, that's a nice color. It's nice and pretty. So at the end, I'm going to see which one tastes better, or if they taste about the same. And this one only takes 30 minutes. And I haven't had 30-something minutes, I think, left. Our bread, batter, dough, or doughs. And now, does this have a third of a cup? Nope. Oatmeal. Nope. Okay. So I need a third a cup of raisins. So I'm going to go get that. They don't have any raisins. I prefer cranberry raisins. And I looked at the ingredients and it just says raisins. So they don't give away any secrets. At least with raisins it says cranberries and sugar and sometimes oil. I think all the time oil. A cup. They're kind of all together. There we go. I'll just let it kind of overflow a little bit. Maybe not that much. There we go. That's more like a healthy third cup. So we're going to fold these in. nice and stay apart. Okay. Folding in our raisin. There we go. And I do really like raisin bread. I don't like raisins by themselves that much. Raisin bread is good. Which is probably why I first bought your soda bread. Okay, I'm trying to disperse them fairly evenly. So it's 30 to 35 minutes, and I'm going to go ahead and just put it on the other sheet because it has about 30 minutes left. Never mind, it won't fit, so I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to butter on this. I'm just going to use the same thing. I'm not going to use my fancy Irish butter. Okay, so now the pan is greased. There we go. Okay. This is really soft dough, so I have high hopes for this flour. And I will maybe make a review. I'm gonna shift my weight. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and put the rest of the dough. It's not like cookie dough, it's fun to eat. So I'm gonna add it. And there's my little loaf. Nice and cute. Shape into a round loaf. Oh, I'm supposed to knead it for a minute. Let's go ahead and do that here. So hopefully it doesn't stick to the pan like this. Definitely sticks to the pan. Okay. So now I'm going to come next into it and put it in. There we go. My hands are covered in dough. Okay. And this one's going smaller, as you might be able to tell. Okay. I'm going to have to clean up now. And, alright, 30 minutes or until golden. Okay, so this loaf, I cut into it earlier and it wasn't cooked all the way, so I put it in the oven. And hopefully it's better now. It still has a little tiny bit of mushiness in the center. I'm going to cut off. And it looks more like the traditional Irish soda bread that I'm familiar with. And it did take longer to cook, basically because I use gluten-free flour. If I can. It's hot. Okay. Oh, hot. So, my bread doesn't look pretty because it's all falling apart. Hopefully that's not a bad thing. And I would say presentation, but based on my bread is because I added flowers. So I'm gonna put normal butter on the normal one and my fancy Irish butter. And I have a fork so I can look like a food critic working ratatouille. Okay, so put as much butter as you like. Mine, not a goblin, but I read that in a fairy tale and I saw it in a movie about goblins. must be true. And if your milk curdles, it means goblins have left nearby. Okay, so first I'm going to try the normal egg white bread. And like I said, I'm going to use a fork so I can look fancy. It's pretty good, but it's not the flavor that you get in stores where they are professional bakers. I'd make it again, but sooner buy it. Well, the crust is nice. It's thick and crunchy. So now I'm going to try my gluten-free with raisins. So obviously I'm going to like it better. It's more traditional. I think this actually has more of an Irish oat bread flavor. And let me go ahead and I'm probably still going to buy some in the stores this year. So, these are both pretty good recipes. This one's easier, this one looks better, and includes raisins. If you don't like raisins, then you don't want it to have as sweet of a taste, then go with the other recipe. Or you can buy it in the store when it is there for like 1 week a year for St. Patrick's Day. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this baking video. It was actually a request. Otherwise, I just, used a bag with, I had milk and eggs and that's it. But I did all the flour and sugar, and also I wanted to make Irish oat bread because it's one of my top three breads for sure. So pretzels are up there. Pretzels, Irish oat bread, and then I guess the third one would alternate, maybe probably sourdough or pumpernickel. So anyway, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and have a happy day or night.